Good evening. The carbon tax is finally in force and Julia Gillard and her senior ministers have been out selling it all over again. While the PM says families will see the benefits, Tony Abbott insists the worst is yet to come. Queensland will be most affected by the carbon tax. Of the 294 affected electricity generators and companies, around 100 call here home. The state government says Queensland will have lost $10 billion by 2020 and up to 21,000 jobs.
Julia Gillard promised we wouldn't have it.
There will be no carbon tax under the government I lead.
That was then, this is now.
Carbon pricing starts today.
Labor MPs are out in force trying to convince voters Julia Gillard's backflip is nothing to be afraid of.
Happy Clean Energy Day.
Senior Minister Gary Gray spending the weekend in Whyalla with his mum, laughing off one of Tony Abbott's predictions.
Whyalla will be wiped off the map by Julia Gillard's carbon tax.
Tony Abbott's really been outrageously misleading and deceitful.
This is a truth campaign. The whole point of a carbon tax is to put prices up.
While Labor politicians are out selling their message, anti-carbon tax protesters have again taken to the street.
Election now!
The carbon tax is a starting price of $23 a tonne. Households don't directly pay the tax. It's paid by nearly 300 of Australia's largest polluters. But there is a flow-on effect to the cost of living.
A modest impact on prices overall, 0.7%, less than 1 cent in the dollar on average.
To help offset the cost, 9 out of 10 households will receive compensation, including tax cuts and increased pension and welfare payments. But in the end, 3 million households will be worse off. Tony Abbott spent the morning with one of those families.
And the gas bill has been going up and up too, hasn't it?
Julia Gillard is hoping that, like the Howard government's GST, most families will find it's not so bad after all.
Once it was in operation, it was clear to all that there was no going back.
But Tony Abbott is adamant it is possible to go back on the carbon tax, and scrapping it is the first thing he'll try to do if he wins the next election.